So if you're thinking of doing a budget gaming build, you're out of luck because, you know, GPU prices are out of this world. Like, think about it. If you want to get like an RX 580 or a Vega 56, it's between $500 and $700. So that takes you out of the budget range. But fear not. Today we're taking a look and we're doing our APU build. This is the brand new AMD Ryzen with Vega 11 APU, which means you don't need a dedicated GPU to start your gaming at 1080p. Now, this is pretty cool. Now, we're using the Ryzen 5 2400G, which courtesy of AMD supplying that one. Tell them thank you very much. This is solid because it still is running on the AM4 socket, which means you can use current Ryzen motherboards out there, but we're using the brand new MSI 350 Pro ITX board, which of course is a really small form factor, so you can go into a really small case with this. Really nice. Also the Rig fan, which comes with the 2400G. So we don't actually have to buy a fan for this. But I do like that motherboard supports two RAM slots on there. You've got HDMI out. You've also got DisplayPort out on this thing too. So you've got all that built in there for you. Now, in terms of storage, we're using the brand new Samsung 860 Pro SSD, V9 SSD. Thanks Samsung for sending that over so we can check it out. This is pretty cool because, you know, you've got read and write speeds about 550 and 530. That's what Samsung states. We got around 525 and 487. So it's actually pretty close to what the stated speeds are supposed to be, which is nice. And again, you can scale up between, you know, all the way up to 512 gigs of RAM storage. I'm gonna say RAM again, sorry. 512 gigs of storage all the way down to about, you know, 64, and different price ranges, well priced, and I think it's pretty solid to use that. Now, our case is from Thermaltake. This is the V1 core case, the Snow Edition. Really nice case, compact, fits the ITX motherboard. You also have a 650 power supply, and some of you are going to be, why 650? That's a little too much. I went with 650 because I'm thinking about upgrading. So what's cool about this is that you can upgrade your CPU, or you can also upgrade the graphics card. So if you want to get a dedicated GPU, you can do that. But the 650 Smart Pro is a really nice power supply. It's also got lighting built into it. As you can see, there's lighting around the whole case. So it's really nice looking. Now, we've done the aesthetics. It looks pretty good. We've got our APU placed in there. We've got, of course, our RAM. We've got our SSD. Everything's powered on. Also, this also has our Wi-Fi built into the motherboard as well. So you've got all that and you connect and you're going, wait, so what am I getting in terms of gameplay? What am I getting in terms of frame rate at 1080p? Well, start off, if you're an Overwatch fan, this is the build for you. This will handle Overwatch like a dream. At medium settings, you're gonna be getting about 56 to about maybe 70 depending, but that's the range in terms of frame rate you're getting with this build. It's really nice, it's solid, and you can game as much as you want. You can also stream at the same time. Now, if you're a CSGO fan, which I'm not really a CSGO player, so I died a lot, you're getting in about 40 to 50, sometimes 70. I would say it's a sizable range, but you're getting some really good frame rates off this, which is nice. So that means you can game well. CSGO fans, absolutely a plus. This will work well for you. Now, when you go into games that have more of a graphical intensity, something like Call of Duty World War II, at low settings, you're getting about 40 frames per second. It handles really well. Actually, it looks pretty good. 1080p low settings, 40, 45 frames per second there. Now, a game like Doom, which is low settings, you're getting about 35 to 40 frames per second. Still handles very, very well. Now, I tried to max it out and say, okay, let me try out a game like Witcher 3. Ran really slow, it's getting about 12 frames per second, not something you want to do or game with. So you kind of know the games you can actually use and play with something like the brand new Ryzen with Vega 11 APU. Overwatch, CSGO, games like that, you can definitely play and enjoy them to the fullest capacity. And I'll say that, look, this is a nice way to start your gaming adventure. You don't have to spend too much. In terms of pricing, you've got a nice cost-effective APU, the Ryzen 5 2400G at $169. You've got, of course, the SSD from Samsung, starts at $94 at the lowest storage level. You've got RAM, you know, the G-Skill RAM, the case, all that stuff is relatively inexpensive. And it will keep you well under $500. And that's a really good place to start. And I like what I'm getting performance-wise. I'll be doing another video where I'm gonna add a GPU GPU, dedicated GPU to this to see what kind of performances I get with the dedicated GPU. Hopefully I can get a Vega 56 at a cost-effective price. But there you have it, guys. That's our AMD Ryzen with Vega APU build. Any questions or any comments, let me know. Now also, if you're a fan, you follow us, and you check out our community page where we post a lot of questions, go over there after watching this video. We've got something really cool for you. You get to win something awesome. It's for fans, you know where the community page is, so that's where I'm going to basically honor you guys. So thank you very much. Again, like, share, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and hit that notification icon once you do. And this is Thunder E saying thank you, and always enjoy your entertainment. Are you scared of losing trust? Will you be asking for some space? Will you be lying to his face? And I guess you'll never learn. I know it's none of my concern.